Additional evidence is thoroughly laid out in my written testimony, but frankly, nothing could capture the breadth of this problem better than one recent yet fairly common example that should infuriate every person in this room.
Ms. Swear, I read your testimony, and I believe in all fairness, since we did not invite the Cook County State's Attorney's Office to be represented here today, that you shouldn't really zero in on any particular individual. If you want to speak to the trends, that's certainly your right, but because that decision was made by the committee to keep this more at the federal level, I hope you'll respect that.
Well, I was called to Chicago to testify in front of the Senate Judiciary Committee in a Chicago field hearing specifically on gun violence and gun trafficking in Chicago. And so one of the points that I wanted to bring up was the reality of how some of these rogue progressive prosecutors, some of these very lenient prosecutorial tactics of not charging offenders of gun violence and letting them get off scot-free, how that really matters and acts as a driving force behind this gun violence. And as I was about to explain and highlight a very well publicized example of this from Chicago from just a couple months ago, Senator Durbin interrupted. He actually ended up interrupting twice during this to explain that he didn't think it was appropriate for me to talk about this. On the one hand, the public officials who I invoked were not there to defend themselves. And then at another point, he seemed to imply that, well, this was just too Chicago specific. This was too localized, talking about local prosecutors. It didn't give Congress necessarily anything to work with, both of which were sort of, it's astounding in itself to interrupt a witness's opening statement. That's almost unheard of. I've never had it happen before. I've never seen it happen before. But then to raise those factors as, you know, sort of couch it under the guise of those factors is, it's just mind-boggling. Again, this was a very well-publicized story at the time, not just the day of, but, you know, some of the ramifications of it afterward. So in early October of this year, there was a shootout in a residential neighborhood of Chicago. You had four individuals who drove up and opened fire on a house. Individuals inside that house appear to have fired back. In total, it looks like there were over 70 rounds fired. One person was killed. Two people were injured. It appears to have been part of an intra-gang dispute. And astonishingly, this was all caught on camera. Law enforcement officers did their jobs. This happened on a Friday morning. I believe just a couple hours later, they had five suspects who were arrested. They wanted them charged with all manner of, you know, murder, attempted murder, probably a slew of gun charges that could have been, you know, filed against them. By Monday morning, all five of these individuals had been released, not just on bond, not with bail, but without any charges whatsoever. There have been no charges filed. There's no pending charges. They just appear to have lit up a residential neighborhood on a Friday and were let go entirely on a Monday.
Some of the retailers downtown in Michigan Avenue, I will tell you, I'm disappointed that they're not doing more to take safety and make it a priority. For example, we still have retailers that won't institute plans like having security officers in their stores, locking up their merchandise at night, chaining high-end bags. These purses seem to be something that is attracting a lot of attention on these organized retail theft units.
This is absolutely astonishing that this would be the response. It is not, wow, we need to ramp up law enforcement efforts. We need to deter crime. We need public officials to do their jobs. But hey, you victims, could you try a little bit harder to not be victims? That's not why we fund police. That's not why we fund prosecutors. It's even more astonishing coming from what it appear to be, you know, the more progressive, left-leaning public officials who, on the one hand, will say, well, nobody needs guns because that's the job of law enforcement. It's the job of law enforcement. You know, stop being vigilantes trying to keep yourself safe. Leave that to the professionals. And then at the same time, turn around and say, well, why are you expecting the professionals to do this? Why haven't you hired security yourself? Why don't you take care of it yourself? So it's just inconsistent, but also just, you know, again, a weird way of framing the issue. You know, why haven't you tried a little bit harder to not be a victim?